grammar, they will say there's 5, 6 past plurals for this word. I can't say that. But I can tell you when you make a mistake. And I can use it correctly, inshallah. There are 8. I haven't prepared for this, so you'll have to bear with me and be kind. So, in Arabic, I know Arabic grammar very well, because I've studied that. Most of my time is in the Arabic language, not English. But my highest qualifications are in English. But most of the time was in Arabic. So, everybody participates in this. So this is the English grammar, but they don't tell you how many. In English, there are 3 parts of words are in 3 parts. That's Arabic. Very easy. In English, there are 8.
8 parts of speech.
Yes. 8 parts of speech. So, inshallah, we're meant to be doing Arabic grammar, English grammar now. The Arabic was earlier, 4 o'clock. So, who's going to tell me the parts of speech in English?
Pronoun.
Preposition. Adverb, we've got, yes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, one more. It's not in this book, should be. Field. I studied what I had to do, but I said mine is in English literature. That's what I'm best at. I was teaching boys that only studied English with me for a year, but they were speaking quite a lot. After 1 year, I was teaching them Shakespeare, and they understood it. 1 year, they're very smart boys, Malay boys. I was speaking to them Shakespeare. I said, I'm surprised. How can you say Shakespeare for 1 year? So, but I'm not an expert in grammar. Inshallah, when you speak it, I hope you speak it correctly. One of the hardest things in English grammar, the tenses. The tenses of the verb, that's very difficult. But inshallah, we'll get to that through this book. But it's a good book, but it's not perfect. Like, he hasn't written the articles yet. It's not the articles yet. He hasn't got all the parts of speech. But as I said, it's not important to... it's all stuck here. This is all Malay, 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 Malay. And they're talking about nouns. Katanamo. Katanamo. Nouns. That's plural. Can anyone define what a noun is? Who can define a noun? Tell me what a noun is.
A name of the self, beliefs, and things.
Name of person, place,
things.
Things, one more.
Animal.
Name of. As I said, I'm an expert, that's why I had to think for a second, but I know it. It's just that I don't, like if someone came in here and had my qualifications but in English grammar, they'd tell you that 6 past parables for this word. I can't tell you that. But I can use it, inshallah. So I want everybody to give me an example. It's the name of people, places, animals or things. I did. Can you give me an example? Don't talk. Turtle. Tiger, that's animal as well. Manusia, you can do anything. Student, you give me a name of someone. Places. Yeah, whatever you want to do. Animals you gave me already. Tiger, what else did you give me? Horse. You gave me something else, that's all right. Things? Hold on. Pen. Whiteboard. Seat. Etc. There's millions, hundreds of them anyway. So that's a noun. Name of people, places, animals, or things. I did memorize all these. Ta'arif, they call it, definitions, but I don't remember them, that's too many years ago. Pronoun. I don't know if it's got this here or not. It's got some, yeah. I've got some good books in English grammar, but just English, and they're very difficult. I don't know if I can use them with you. I'll try. But this seems fairly good. Yeah, it's okay. It's not perfect, but it's all for a start. We can use it anyway. Pronouns. Who can give me an example of a pronoun? Yes. You, he, she. Oh, we start with the first person. You go, I. Plural is we. Then you go to the second person, you. Female or male, doesn't matter. Plural. You. Malay's different, Arabic's different. You. Female or male, doesn't matter. Or mixed. The student came out of the classroom, he carried his books, or she carried her books. But if they came out, boys, girls, everyone together, they came out. You, singular, plural, male, female, doesn't matter. You came here and paid us up here. How many people? One, two, doesn't matter. In English, doesn't matter. Girls or boys, doesn't matter. Female, male. If you're going to speak with animals, we can also use that. You don't have to speak with animals. Alright, that's pronouns. This is very quickly because each one goes into a lot of detail. Adjective. Adjective. Give me an example of an adjective. The duster, the red duster, that's right. The white board, the
wide
white board.
Not
I'll see that. Nefer, Sifa, or Nak? You use a little Nan. Nak? Nak Sulman. Sifa, Jamal, Sifat, or Al Saf. Nak, in English, you have to pronounce the last letter. Malays, especially from this state, they don't pronounce the last letter. In English, you must. Wide white board. Wide white board. Not white white board. No. Because okay. That becomes you. You said wide or white? I can't hear. Wide or white? Wide white board. So you must pronounce the D.
Wide.
Read that first. In English. Three. That's right. This one? Well, actually, that's not the word I want to. I want something else. 30. What's the word of the Lord? That's the word of what?
13.
So you must pronounce 13. So you must pronounce, if it's got an N on the end of it, you must pronounce the 19. Sometimes I can't hear, did you say 9 or 19? I can't tell you. Must, in English you must pronounce last letter. 19.
You put a syllable. Syllable.
Yeah, it is a separate syllable. Yes. But if you learn Tajweed, you know that you must have that Tanween 19. No, I didn't. same as here. Wide, white, wide, white. Different words. Sometimes I can't tell, because especially in the state here, they don't finish the word. I don't know Malacca what they do in Malacca. The same as the Glatte. But sometimes, boys from Slango can't understand local people in Malacca. Just come study in Pondo Pastumo, they can't understand. So, important, whether it's 13 or 30, 19 or 90, you must make it clear. Wide, white. Pronounce that last letter, please. If you go anywhere in the English speaking world, they want to make sure that you pronounce the last letter. What was I talking about? Adjectives. Sorry, you'll have to be loud, I can't hear.
What is noun, pronoun, and adjective? You are just telling me this now. What is noun? Not the meaning, but what is noun?
Noun is the name of a person, place, thing.
Pronoun.
Pronoun is a word that takes the place of a noun. So when this is very early, but if you come to write English, you don't say the name of a thing again and again and again and again, except there's one exception. I came to the classroom and there were 10 chairs in the room. I sat on one chair, that chair was blue in colour. No, you don't say that. I came to the classroom and there were 10 chairs. I sat in one of them, and its colour was blue. There's one exception, but it's not an English, it's a religious exception, that's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Love will jalada. Every time we come across it, Allah's words himself in the Quran, in Hadith, and also just when you're speaking, you say, I prayed to Allah last night. I asked Allah to forgive my sins. I asked Allah to help my mother. That's okay. In English, it's okay. In Malay, probably it's okay. In Arabic, it's okay. Because each time you use the word love of Jalala, Allah, you get reward. So that's the exception. But apart from that, use he, she, it when you take the place of that. After the first use. So I came into the room and saw Mahmoud was sitting down. Mahmoud got up and gave the salam. Mahmoud then shook my hands. Mahmoud then took my books and put them on the table. Mahmoud then, first time. I came into the room and Mahmoud greeted me first time. He then took my books. He then, you keep repeating it without, and if you've written a paragraph, yes, that's okay. And also, it doesn't matter how soon, but if there's two men in the room, was he talking about Mahmoud or was he talking about Ahmad? So if it's not clear, repeat it, that's okay. If it's not clear, because I came to the room and I found Ahmad and Mahmoud were sitting there. You can't use he there because it's... You say, well, it's straight after it. You use it straight away. No, because there's two people, Mahmoud and Ahmad. I walked in the room and saw Ahmad and Mahmoud sitting there. Ahmad gave salam. That's okay. It's perfect good English. If you use he, that's wrong. You don't know which one was the first or the second one. You don't know. All right. That's pronouns. A word that takes the place of a noun. Okay. Adjectives. We talked about adjectives. See further.
Word that describes a noun.
Word that describes a noun, yes. Word that describes a noun. Adjective is a word that describes a noun. Be that it be. It's colour, shape, size, or any other characters. Doesn't matter. It's what's the difference? Is that correct there or not? It's colour.
It's belong to the...
Yeah.
It's colour.
That one. Without apostrophe. When do you use it's with apostrophe S? Yes.
Short form of it is.
It is big. It is a hot day. It is. But it's showing possession. Possession? No, you don't use it. Something else I want to say. Oh, colour.
American spelling.
American, don't use it.
Hey, you know where we are. American.
It's American, wrong. In Malaysia, Australia, UK. Oh, you are.
You are.
There are many words. Bishal will come across them. When we come across them, we'll sometimes it's double. They don't like double letters in America. They use one singular. But Bishal, when we come across them, we'll point them out. Something else I want to say? If you want to ask something, just ask me. Sometimes I forget what I want to say.